Hi guys, it's Cal from Nerdy Weasel, and today we got an Inigo special. You know, we did a update installation for Inigo version 2 and went over how to do that, how to get to that point. And I just wanted to give you an update on a couple points. Now, in the original video, we had some problem with amazing follower tweaks, also known as AFT. It didn't quite want to mesh with Inigo, and it was hanging on by its dear little grubby paws to have control over him. Now, in the solutions section under the post for Inigo on the Nexus page, in the sticky part you'll see Madrias' solution to that, and you can go ahead and read that and learn how to get AFT from controlling Inigo. But I'll leave that to you and to read it. I've decided to not even have it in my load order. I've decided that Inigo is my only follower and there's no need for anything else. So we're going to cover a couple things today. We got a little map thing we got to do with Inigo, and we're going to buy him a horse. He needs his own horse. He'll probably name it too. He's really good about that. So let's get right into game and we'll go see Inigo. Try and fix Inigo up here. So we got some things to do, Inigo. I think you probably have something to tell me.
My friend, Skyrim is a big and often confusing place.
It is very big.
We are bound to lose each other from time to time. Never fear. That map you have is special.
It's special? How is it special, Inigo? This whole thing? I don't get it. How so?
Let me show you. My brother once found one just like it on the remains of some poor old adventurer.
A reference to your brother.
It does not only mark locations, it can also show the position of items and people too.
Wow, that's very interesting, Inigo.
Where are you, Inigo?
Inigo. Okay.
There. See, I have placed myself on your map.
So we have a quest?
All you need to do is look me up.
Alright, well, it is pretty fantastic. Thank you, Inigo. That's great. Thank you very much. Let's take a look at this. We'll turn on the map, and what you need to do is start your journal. And you can see Inigo, where are you? And if you activate the quest, and it shows an Inigo map marker. Inigo marked himself on my map, so I can always find him if we become separated. Well, that's very handy. So let's see. Yep. Inigo map marker. That's Inigo. There he is. So if we need to find him, that's where he'll be. So we'll come out of this, and we got something to do, Inigo. I need
to
trade something with you.
I will bear your burdens gladly.
Yeah, we're gonna take that silly looking helmet off of you. There we go. You're still holding your shield, kind of funny.
Okay, let us get back to
You know, we got something to do. So this involves Valdar's horse. You know, I like Valdar's horse. And I want to keep him, but you know, with your new update, you don't have a horse of your own. So we need to go buy you one. And in the early parts of the playthrough, we had you on a Pinto. There's a Pinto for sale over there. So I think we need to go buy you one. So come on, Inigo. Let's go buy you a horse. Are you following? Yeah, Valdor's horse is staying. I kept him there. I don't want to have Valdor's horse too close, because this will kind of mess up with Inigo. More cars looking very pretty today. Nice day. So, where's the horse stable at? There he is. Hello, stable master. Markar Stables. Are you Cedron? Do you sell this horse? I want that horse. Inigo wants that horse.
You need a reliable horse in reach.
Yeah, I can. Can I buy a horse?
All saddled and ready to go. What are you willing to pay?
Can I barter, haggle a little bit? You know, it's all about the haggling. I want the horse. $1,000 gold is way too much. How can you charge so much for a bi-colored horse? You're supposed to come back with a second offer. No? Not gonna do that? Okay.
Sounds fair. She's yours. Like I said, she's all set.
Okay. I'd like to buy a horn, please. Nah, I don't think we need to buy a horn. I'll buy a horn anyways. Take the Nordic horn.
Thank you. Here, this is for you.
I don't know if an eagle will need it or not, but we're gonna buy one anyways. So, nope, that's not my horse. Ah, there's my horse. So he's already got the that says Valdor's horse. So he's already got the Nordic saddle, which I kind of like for Inigo. So we'll jump on this horse and we'll pull it out here. Woo! Pull it out. Okay, pull out the horse. Okay, it's out of the garage. Ooh, it's so disorienting. I like it. Okay, Inigo. So we'll have to change that. You know, convenient horses basically changed him over to the Dawn Guard. I want to change that. So we'll go into system, mod configuration, convenient horses, horses. I want where's the Nordic saddle? I want the Nordic saddle on that horse. There he goes, the Nordic saddle for Inigo. I think that fits you best. So, we're going to come over to Inigo.
Yes, my friend.
Mind if I ask you something?
Go ahead, ask away.
And I want to give you a horse, Inigo. See, you're going to have this painted horse. Do you think that's going to be all right for you?
Really?
Yes, really. Yes, take my Markarth horse. He's yours.
That lovely patchwork horse with a killer smile and apples on his breath?
What yes.
A gift.
He's
Thank you.
The horse that's getting pushed around.
All set?
Yeah. Well, you're going to need to jump on the horse, Inigo. Quit letting the guy push it around. I'm going to go back and get Valdor's horse. So I got to be over this way. I know you'll follow me. We'll come back for the painted horse in a second. So we got a couple things done today. Inigo told me about his map markers, and we got him a horse. Oh, okay. So that's right. So when we bought the new horse, the old horse went back to Riften. So we'll be fast traveling to Riften and wait for him there. So guys, we're at the Markarth stables. I had to wait an extra 24 hours, but Valdor's horse is back. Let's jump on Valdor's horse. And you can see Inigo's horse is there, so we can get off. And I can reset Valdor's horse's armor. Now that he's been ridden once, I can go ahead and change his armor again through convenient horses. Whoa, Inigo, what you doing? You think you're on your horse, don't you? Okay. So we will now reset Valdor's horse back to his old armor setting. Convenient horses. Horses. I want my Dawn Guard saddle back. So I think it looks good. There he is. So we got. I better ride. Better ride. Inigo, get on your horse. Inigo, get on your horse.
I think I will call my new steed Fledge. He is a lovely horse, and he deserves a lovely name.
Pledge? You called him Pledge. You called your horse Pledge. Okay. Well, all right. Pledge. You have a horse named Pledge. You have a horse named Pledge that is painted. That's kind of weird, Inigo. I gotta say, that's kind of weird. So, a couple notes about Inigo's horse is that he will not have combat while on it. So, if you were a combat guy, yep, did not stand a chance. So he's not gonna fight anymore for you if you're horseback. But he will fast travel, and he names his horse, so that's kind of cool. So we'll go ahead and, you know, I guess I got to do all the fighting now from horseback. And that's fine. And you'll have to protect him, because unlike convenient horses, they don't run away from danger if Inigo owns him, but that's okay. And we'll call him. But the horse will ride with him, and he names it, so that's kind of nice. And there's home. So, Inigo has a horse. He showed me his map today. Or it's my map, but it's my, with his marker on it. So we got a couple things done with, we got wolves about. There he is. All right. So.
So the tongue speaks, the mountain winds reach.
So you can see it gets off relatively quickly. Oh, we're going to go into combat, but we're not going to do that right now. Inigo's going to go off and fight some wolves, I think. My name's Cal, I'm from Dirty Weasel. That's Inigo going into battle. And we're signing off.
For his story is over, and the dragon.